In this tutorial, I will demonstrate the steps of importing and editing clips to make a complete video using Adobe Spark. And you can search online for the Adobe Spark homepage. Adobe is always updating and offering new features, so this screen may look a bit different. You can click Start Now, and if you have an account already, you can sign in with Google, etc. But if you don't have an account, you can sign up with your email and create the account for free. I have an account, so I'm going to go ahead and sign in, and it's connected to my Google. My page may look different than yours. So scrolling down, you'll see my previous projects and lots of fantastic customizable templates. Back at the top, you have all of the different types of projects you can create, and we're going to click on slideshow, which is actually the same as a video. Start by typing in a title for your project, which you can change later, and I'll be using the footage of my cats Winston and Clementine. Click Next. And you can also use one of these templates as the basis for your video, or you can choose to start from scratch. On this next screen at the bottom, you'll see slides where you can add your video clips and credits. In the middle of the slide, you click on the plus sign, and here is where you can add your media. Over on the far right, you have options for formatting the film, and up top, you have your options for when your film is done. So when you're ready, your first step is in the center to click on the plus sign to add your first video clip, which is saved to my downloads folder. I took these videos with my phone and I sent them to my computer using Google Drive. I also suggest naming your files so that you will know the order that they will go in. I'll click on scene one and then open. This will open the video into an editing window, and you can drag this on the timeline to adjust the segment of the clip that you would like to use. You can also adjust your start and your stopping points, which will expand or trim the clip as much as you like. Press the little play button here to preview your adjusted clip. And the little clock over here shows you the total length of that adjustment. You can save your clip to get back to the main screen, and you can also play your adjusted clip using this play button as well. With that clip selected in the upper right corner of the screen, you've got some editing options. You can zoom out or you can zoom in. You can also click to go back to the editing window to trim again. And you can continue the clip onto the next slide. This might be necessary if your clips are long. No transitions will be added, so you won't have to worry about continuity. Some of the other editing features have to do with the audio for this clip, and you can make the audio louder, softer, or you can mute it altogether. You can also click on the plus sign on the clip to add an icon or text. Maybe you want to add the title of your film to this clip. And rest assured that Spark is going to underline with red any misspelled words. You can also use the icons up above to change the size of your text. And you can use the trash can to delete the text if you need. To add more clips, click on the plus sign in the bottom left corner to get a new slide, and you can continue adding all the clips that you'd like. I'll speed up this part as I do repeat those same steps, and I have the clips labeled in order beforehand, which helps make this process much easier. Now you see I have 7 clips added, and over on the right side, I can change the layout of these clips, such as this split screen instead of a full screen. I can also add a caption or a title, and captions tend to play nicer with the color options that are available for the different themes that you can apply to your film. Each of the themes having a different style of font, and some have colored overlays. You can also choose to resize the ratio aspect of your film, going from widescreen, which is great for YouTube and computer screens, to square, which is good for posting on social media. You'll see that it applies the size to all of your clips. Note that if you change the size, you can click to edit the clip, and you can click and drag to move the footage within that screen. Here's a troubleshooting tip. If you ever can't edit a clip, like the editing tools are not showing up for you, then go ahead and click on the spark icon on the left-hand side to exit out of your project. And then on your main screen, you can click back on your project to begin editing again. This usually fixes any glitches. The last option on the right-hand side is the option to add music. And you can use some of the royalty-free music that has been provided by Adobe, or you can add your own music. You can also adjust the volume or turn the music off completely. To add a voiceover, you can press and hold on the microphone at the bottom of the clip to record your own voice as you speak. As it says, you can re-record this as many times as you want. Along the bottom in the timeline, you can click on clips and rearrange them as you like. You can also click and get the menu to delete, duplicate, or play the video from that clip forward. Click this play button in the bottom left corner to play the video in its entirety. And you can add your own end credits on this slide, and you can customize the final slide with the logo, but that's more for a brand for a company. When your film is finished, up top you can preview your film in another window and play it through. You can also share your video by publishing it first. You'll choose a title, which can be the same from the beginning, a category, and if you're under the age of 18, I recommend just using your last initial as the author for some privacy. Once it's published, you now can have a link that can be copied and shared out, and you can also share by posting it onto social media. Back on the main screen, you have another option of downloading the file, and this will save to your downloads as an MP4 file. And this MP4 can be played on any computer device. You can invite others to view this video. And you can also add people like your instructor or teammates if you want to work on the same video as a group. Spark has been auto-saving your work, so you can just exit by clicking on the icon in the upper left corner. And back on this home screen, you'll see your project. If you hover over it, you can click to edit it, or you can click on the three dots and bring up some more options. You can again share it by inviting other people or publishing it. You can duplicate it or move it into a folder. You can organize your work into folders. You can also rename your project or download it, delete it, find it, or unpublish it. So those are the steps of importing and editing clips to make a complete video using Adobe Spark. And without further ado, here is the debut of When Winnie Met Clemmy. When Winnie first met Clemmy, he found her to be very ferocious and intimidating. She would tear up her toys like no other cat he had ever seen. Clemmy was determined in her pursuit to antagonize and torment Winnie. But slowly, over time, Clemmy started to find Winnie less like prey and more like entertainment. They began to discover that they liked spending time together and found that they actually had very similar interests. They began to relax around one another and start to enjoy spending time together. And it's possible that they could even live happily ever after. Or maybe not.